In this lecture, we will see module and the package. Functions can be shared, but sometimes the call is complicated and not easy to be shared. Therefore, we will convert functions to a module or a package to solve the above issues. Welcome back to Python Programming Foundation. We knew what is function, lambda, recursive function. If we want to give our function lambda or recursive function to other guys, what will we do? We can use module, this kind of new file, to give other guys our functions lambda and the recursive functions. A module, you can treat a module as a code library, like this sentence, consider a module to be the same as a code library. That means you can directly use this module and its functions to do something in your main code. And this module will be generated as a file. And this file must use .py file format in Python. Like this shows, a file contains a set of functions you want to include in your application. And to create a module, just save the code you want in a file with the file extension .py. Because in Python, .py executable file and it can execute it in Python. So you can merge your function in a module file. And then other guys wants to use your function, then it can include your file, .py file, and then call your function and use your function to do the things he or she wants. And if you want to include the module file in Python, you need to use import module, this statement, to use the whole module. And that means if this module have many functions, then you can use all functions in this module. For example, the module file names abc.py, and then in this module there are three functions. Suppose this is abc1, abc2, and abc3. Then after you import module, then you can call abc1, abc2, abc3 functions, and you can pass the parameters to this function and do the function thing and get the return value if possible. In other words, you can use abc1, abc2, abc3, three functions in your main code. On the other hand, if you just want to use one function, then you can use from module import function or this statement to use one function. Take the same example. We import abc, this py file. Then we use from abc import function abc1. Then in your main code, you only use abc1, this function. As for abc2 and abc3, these two functions, you cannot use because you don't import them to your main code. So this is the module. You can create a module and contain your function, and then pass this module file to other guys. Then the other guys can use import module or from module import function to use your function in the module. If we have a lot of module, then we can let them to be a package. A package you can treat as a folder. I have a package. Then in this package, I have a lot of module. And for each module, I have many functions. Okay, so we can use the folder and the module and the function to import the functions. Okay, a package has many modules, like a folder has many files. Okay, and if I want to use the module in a package, then I can use from package import module, and then I can use this module's functions, all functions. And if I only want to use one function, then I can use from package dot module import function, this statement, to just use one function. Okay, and this is the module and the package. And in short, a module and a package is used to pass your function to other guys, and then the other guys can use packages and the function and the module and to call your functions. Later, we will see other examples and that will use module and the package. Okay, it is our first example for module and the package. This is the power function and the module. That means we can do it by function or by module. Okay, this is our first example. This example asks us implement a program to calculate the value of x to the power y. That means x power of y. Besides, please write one line of code to input x and y and convert string to integer in each variable. And note that cannot use the built-in function power because in Python, we have POW, this power function. We can directly use to calculate the x power y. So we cannot use the built-in function. And we have two hints. The first one is string.split can split a string into a list where each word is a list item. Second, lambda and the map function can help you meet the input requirement. That means you can use string.split or lambda or map, or you don't use this, it's okay. And for the example, we have input in one line of code like 3 and 4. That means we want you to calculate 3's power of y, 4. X is 3 and y is 4. And the output will be 81. 3 multiple 3 multiple 3 multiple 3 equals to 9 multiple 9 equals to 81. And here, you can use three ways to solve this question. The first one is use function to implement the program. Second is use recursive function to implement. And the third is use module to implement. And the third way is our package and the module. So we think about the first one, use function. Use function, you can think that we define a function, means power, a and b, okay? And result is 1. Okay, for I in range b, our result is multiple the a of b times. That means a multiple a multiple a multiple a b times. And then we can get the a power of b. Then we can return the result. Okay, this is a function does. And for the main call, well, we can use that. Input, let the user input x and y, and we will calculate this. And then we can use the split, this is a string split, to separate x and y. Then we can get x is the first content of the list, and the y is the second content of the list. Their index is 0 and 1, respectively. Then we can use the print, is x equal x, y equal y, and then we can calculate the power of y, then x power of y, then we can get the result like this one, print s y 3 and 4, and x equal to 3, y equal to 4, and then we can get the value of x is 81. Okay, this is use the function and the split. Of course, you can modify this code to be a lambda or the map. Okay, and for the second one, we use the recursive function, and we can see that define power a and b. Okay, and if a equal to 0, that means we return 0 because 0's power are 0, so a is 0. And then if b is 0, then return 1 because any numbers power 0 is 1. And then else if b equal 1, that means we return a. So we can use recursive. Otherwise, we return a multiple power a comma b minus 1. And this will be like a multiple a multiple a multiple a until a b times. And then we can get a power b. Okay. So we can see the print. This is the same. And the different here, we use the list and the map and the lambda to replace the code in function this way. And we can see that Input is here. Please input X and Y. And then user input the X and Y. And we use a split to separate X and Y to value. And then we use the lambda or X. And the result is the integer. Let the string to be an integer. And use the map to let the x and y from the string format to be the integer format and to let them be a list, and x and y will be the first number and y to be a second number, and then we can use the recursive function to get the x to the power y, and this is use the recursive function. And if we want to use module, that means we need to let our function to be a py file. Okay, so you can use the second way, recursive function to be a py file, or you can use the function here to be a py file. And here we choose this one. This is a simple one to be a py file, and we call this a power.py. So we import power, means we will import power.py. You can see that here. You can see here power.py. Define power A and B. Okay, and then we can get the A, the power of B. Okay, so this is the power.py. This is the module. Then we can use it in here or import power. P-O-W-E-R, power. Or the name is the same as the module's file's name. And then we can use here. This is the same as the above code. So we augment this. And when we want to use the function, remember, we need to use the power. This is the module's name. And then that means module's function. And our function calls power. Okay, so we can call this function and do the things. Okay, recall it. Power, the first power is the module's name or import power. And for the second power is the function's name. Or you can see this one. Our power.py, this is the module's name. And the function name also called power. So when we use this one, we need to use module's name.function's name and the parameters. Okay. And this is the first example. Okay, for the second example, that means you have a game package. That means we have a package. And in this package, there are two modules called dice and poker, respectively. Okay, so if we see the package, we can see that this is, we have the package game. We can treat it as a folder. And in this package, we have a dice and the poker, and this is also in py file format. That means it can be a module. If you use other file format, then it cannot be a module. Okay, we have a package game, and in this game we have two module, dice and the poker. Okay, so this is the question means the dice module can generate a number between 1 and 6, and the other poker can generate a card from the standard 52 card deck, and pre-design a game for two guys to roll the dice. The one who gets the higher number win. And from this example, we will think about this is only use one module, only use the dice module, because this game just roll the dice. Okay, so we can see the dice module. Okay, here. This is a dice module or dice.py. Okay, the content in this file, we can see that random package from random import choice. Then this dice function just return the range between 1 and 6, because 7 is not included and only return one number. Okay, so this is the dice module did. Okay, so we turn back to our main code. We want to use the dice module, so we can use this line from game, this package, import dice module. Okay, and we want to design again for two guys to roll the dice. Then we can see that print that let's play a game. That means we will tell you we will play a game. And to easy the code, we automatically let two person A and B to roll the dice. Okay. We import the dice. Then we want to roll the dice. We will call in dice dot dice. Okay, this dice is the module's name, and the second dice is the function's name. Okay, we can see the dice here. Module's name dice and the function's name dice. And this function doesn't need parameter. Just call it, and it will return the result here. So we call A, get the one number between 1 and 6, and B use the same way. Call the module dice and the function dice, and then get another number. Then we can directly compare these two numbers and to see who get the higher number. Okay. If A is larger than B, then A wins. Then we print A's number and B's number. And otherwise, if A equal to B, that means their numbers are same, so this is tie. And last one, not A is larger than B and not equal to B, that means A is smaller than B, so B wins. Okay, so we can see that A and B get the same number. Okay, so this is use package and the module to solve the question. And for another example, is use poker to design a game for two guys to pick a card from the poker. The one who gets the high card wins. And there are two compressions. The first compression is compare the color, and the order is like this one. S means spread, and H means heart, and D for diamond, and C for the last color. And this order, we can use S is larger than H, and larger than D, larger than C. And then, if we get the same color, then we do the second compression, or that compare their value. And the value is K is the largest, and 1 is the smallest. Okay, so we can compare this by this order. K, Q, J, T, or T means 10. And 9A7654321. And we can think about how to solve this comparison. And before we solve this comparison, we can see the poker module. Okay. This is the poker module. You can see that the poker file name is poker.py or poker.py. And from random import choice. And the poker, we have two lists. The first list is for the color, and the second list is for the value, and then we can get the color plus value, and we can get a card. Okay, and this is the poker. So we can use this poker to get a card. So when we use this one, we use this run game import poker. That means we can use the function in poker. And for the comparison, we can set the different number to this simple. For example, because S is the largest and C is the smallest, so we can define the number to each color. Like S is the 400, and H is 300, and D is 200, and C is 100. And then no matter which value you get, then you just compare the color. Then you can get the result. It's bad for two guys have the same color. Then we will go to the second compression. Okay. For example, if some guy get the S and the other guy, no matter he gets H, D or C, it will lose, and the guy get the S will win. Okay. On the other hand, if the other guy get S, then we will go to the second compression to compare their value. So in the first comparison, we set different number to the S, H, D, and C. like this one. If card S get 400 and H 300, D 200 and C 100. And if they get the same color, then we compare the values. Okay, so this is our think in behind. So we define a function. We call this card convert because we will get the poker because we use a package and the module. Okay, like this one from game import poker. So we can get that poker. This is module da function poker, and we can get a card. And the card is from the color plus value. So we need to separate them. For this one, card convert A, the first content and the second content here. Because we get the result from the poker.poker is a string. Then we can treat a string as a list. Then we can use the first content with the index 0 and the second content for index 1. Okay. Then we can use the convert to convert the string to the number and plus them. For example, if we get the S 3, then we can get S to be a 400 and a 3 to 3, then plus them will be 403. Okay. Then we can use the value to compare the larger and the smaller. So this is the concept. So we can convert the first character of the poker and the second character of poker. Okay, so we can do that or compare them. If it is S, then we can use 400, H 300, D 200, C 100, and K for 13, Q for 12, J for 11, and T for 10. And other are the same. No more need to convert. And then we return it by the integer. Because this is a string, then we need to convert them to the integer. And then the two value can be added. Okay, and similar to B. So we can get the S car, B car, and their corresponding values. And then we can compare these two values. A convert is larger than B convert, then A wins. And if these are same, then this is tie. And otherwise, it's B win. Oh, in this example, A is H3 and B is S2. And H is 300 and 3. And B, S2 means 400 and 2. So B is larger than A. So B wins. Okay, so we can use the package and the module to help us to quickly create a program by ourselves. And also, you can pass your package and the module to other guys if you did a great job in some function. And for the package and the module in Python, there are a lot of package and the module in a lot of core library. You can use them. Like you can use the built-in function in Python, or you can use other famous package, or like NumPy. You can use the NumPy's function to handle your calculation of arrays. And you can use the pandas to handle your file and to do some data cleaning, data processing, and a lot of action in file. And you can use the scikit-learn to do the machine learning, or you can use the Keras to do the deep learning, and so on. Okay. And if you have interest, you can search package or module, or maybe somebody called library in search engine, and then you can use them to do the great job in your Python programming. Okay, so this is the end of the package and the module and the corresponding examples. Hope you understand how to use module and the package to solve problems from this lecture.